trade finance is an important part, and through the private banks in the regions, including in such countries like Georgia and the Armenia and so on, we support trade finance, especially there was a shortage of liquidity after the global financial crisis. But more generally about trade, trade has been, and also foreign direct investment, which is interlinked to the trade, has been the most important kind of contributor to the very rapid growth of Asia, including China, for instance, after the reform and opening up in 1970. So we should keep this open multilateral trade system and the investment regime, and that's what the India is now even further reforming and so on. And I believe that this trend wouldn't change so much, although, of course, the tension between the United States and China should be resolved, and there are some elements of intellectual property rights and technology kind of a rivalry. Mm-hmm. But we should keep this multilateral system. And this multilateral system is supporting Asia, not because we are exporting to other countries, but because also we are trading each other, we are investing each other. So even we look at just East Asian country, ASEAN plus three, China, Korea, Japan, about 50% of FDI and trade are between these countries. It's not between the Europe and America or Asia. So this element, the impetus from trade and the investment will continue to serve Asia, and we should keep it in many ways.